retired. I kind of remember it as a retirement. But then he came back and said, no, I just took a year off. He kept, like, what, 20 dogs, 22 dogs or something in his kennel. And now here he is, and this is Jeff King, four-time champion, and he may be poised to go after a fifth championship.
All I can tell you is he had an outstanding Cusco 300 race, and when I've talked to every other serious top 10 musher, they have all listed Jeff as one of their top three that they're concerned about. They've seen his team in other races through Alaska. More importantly, they've seen Jeff, and a lot of those of us that know him, he's relaxed, calm, and when he's like that, he's bringing something to the game. Not one of the top competitors I've talked to hasn't listed Jeff as one of the top three that they're concerned about this year.
Now, Bruce, you look at him. Obviously, he's the perfect size to be competitive in this. He's an innovator. He knows genetics as well as anybody. He's been around this for so long. But yet there's still something about Jeff King that is not tangible. He's got some intangible quality to him that makes him good at this, doesn't he?
He has competitive drive. I can tell you this, that he played football in high school and college, and he is small build, compact build for a musher, so he could make the football team. He used to put weights in his pocket, so when they weighed in, coach didn't know how small he was. He's just that competitive. He's a person who really enjoys competition. And that's a special attitude to say, I want to get out there and mix it up.
Boy, he was really relaxed when we talked to him today. And you can tell there, he's having a lot of fun, Bruce.
Yeah.
He's a dangerous guy on this trail this year.
If he's close near the front on the Yukon, you've got your hands full. He'll shake it up.
Okay, from Jeff King, a four-time grand champion, to our defending champion, and now 26 years old, is Dallas Seavey, and he is at the line. And you know what's strange? We have him, of course, as one of our contenders, but there's not a lot of people talking about this is Dallas Seavey's race to lose. Oftentimes in this race, you win it, you're the team to beat the next year. Is he the team to beat this year?
Well, I'd say still the team to beat just because of the way he ran last year, and he's very organized, and he didn't have a bad year in training. I think there's a lot of teams to beat this year, but if you want to win, you got to beat him. And I don't expect to see that just being a quick flash of a falling star last year's race. He's getting this for the long run. He's in this for the career, and he's grown up with it. If he doesn't win, he'll be right there near the front. It's interesting as they're going out here that a lot of our really super highly competitive mushers are going out early this year in the pack.
He has not been out of the top 10 since he quit running his dad's puppy teams and began his own kennel. And this guy, I mean, this was in his early 20s.
Right, and but then he separated from his dad. I mean, he's doing this on his own. People think he's following Mitch. They're good friends. They talk dogs. But Dallas has his own kennel, and we're just seeing his kennel genetics come together. He just started his own competitive kennel. So I expect this team to be stronger than last year's, and I expect his next year's team to be stronger than this one. This is a kennel on the rise.
Speaking of rise,
he almost ran into the camera.
Well, I mean, he told us last year at the end of the race that his team was in the valley. He felt like his kennel was in a valley, that it hadn't reached its pinnacle yet, and it already won. And so now at the line, wearing bib number 20, is Christy Barrington, now in her fourth race. She's very serious about this. Now 29 years old, she has dreams of winning it someday. Her finishes are 44th, 29th, and 39th, but she's gaining experience. And who knows down the road. Took John Baker, what, 16 tries before he won?
Can take a long time to learn this, but she's worked with some good mushers in the past down on the Kenai, Paul Gephardt, and there's a whole contingency of good mushers down there, Dean Osmar, and they pick up a lot of experience in a hurry, and you can kind of jump to the front of this thing, but seems like she's staying pretty steady at it. 2010, 2011, 2012, and now she's back again. So I think she's going to be around for a little while.
It's a good-looking dog team. Kind of your standard-looking Alaskan Husky. You're the dog guy. What do you see here?
If I look at these dogs, I see dogs that kind of look like dogs that I would expect to come from that area of Alaska. Dean Osmar was one of the top mushers out of there. And I see dogs here that are a little smaller, and I also see dogs that are a little heavy furred for a day like today where it's so warm.
Christy Barrington on her way. This is the start from downtown Anchorage, 4th Avenue. We're live, and we're right back.